Every weeknight after 12 News at 10, Nightline hits the air. Since Nightline's debut in 1980, it has become a way to elaborate on the day's news.
And 12's Joyce Garbasiak recently traveled to ABC Studios in New York to get an inside look at Nightline.
Kathy, Jason, Nightline anchor Terry Moran insists that when it comes to news coverage, go to the source and listen intently. This year, he's listening to Wisconsin.
From the global resources of ABC News, this is Nightline.
Three, two.
Kathy and Jason coming up next on Nightline.
Jennifer Nightline Lopez anchor Terry Moran relishes the chance to take time.
We can take viewers in depth in a story in a way that is rare on television.
There are rumors swirling around this city about an imminent crackdown, but the people here are unyielding.
Moran says the show's nightly 30-minute format allows for spending as much time as necessary on the big story of the day, from national to world news.
Chanting, "We are Egypt."
From politics to entertainment.
Coming up on Nightline, Jennifer Lopez.
We know our viewers have a hunger for news. What have you come to learn about that appetite nationwide? I mean, do people really want news and information in the amount that they're getting?
I actually think that's a hugely dynamic time in the media industry. A lot of change for newspapers, for television stations, for networks. In part, that's because people want more. And they want more reality.
It is a tough year for Democrats, isn't it? What are you doing to try and help these guys?
I think one of the things Nightline tries to do is make it fresh, make it new. We have a team approach to it, so it's not quite as much the way it used to be done.
With Terry Moran, Cynthia McFadden, and Bill Weir in New York City.
With the three co-anchor format, one reports the news, leaving the other two free to travel and cover stories, a change from Moran's previous job when he worked at the White House.
Do you miss not being at the White House and that beat?
I do. When you're in the White House press corps, they keep you basically in the security bubble and you never break out. You learn an incredible amount. Every day there's something happening in the world or in the government or in American politics that you learn something about. You got to get up to speed on. So I do miss that. I miss the sheer intensity of it. But that kind of prison atmosphere that the White House,
not
so much. I'm glad to be free.
Though not in the White House bubble, he is still in the loop, still securing big political interviews.
Define victory in Afghanistan, or maybe that's not the right word.
And he's intrigued by the role Wisconsin will play in next year's presidential race.
It's amazing what's happening there. Absolutely. And the recall elections, sort of focusing the country's attention on these divisions which run right across the country. So absolutely, Wisconsin is it's critical. I don't think the Democrats can win without it. And there's a target of opportunity, really, for the Republicans as well.
Moran says he'll be watching, listening, and reporting, making sure Nightline is on top of the story. Terry Moran has been with Nightline since 2005. He likes the combination of anchoring and reporting and thinks his time covering the White House was invaluable.
Mm-hmm. Well, you mentioned he had Midwestern roots. He does, doesn't he?
He does. You know, he was born in Illinois, one of 10 kids, and he graduated from Lawrence University in Appleton in 1982. He still spends time in Wisconsin. He even vacationed this past summer in Door County.
Small world.